I'll always remember my first 100 pound plus Nile perch from Egypt's massive Lake Nasser. So here it is with a taste of perch from the shore first. They're so aggressive, Nile perch, and the takes are like lightning. They appear from behind a rock, from absolutely nowhere, and you think, well, where was that? And all of a sudden, it's there, and they don't like a meal getting away, but they do leave it until the last minute to attack. I can see the dead bait now. I'm giving it a bit of a twitch. Oh, that looks lovely in that clear water. Can't see if anything's following at the moment, but right at the last minute, a small fish shot out from the rocks then. Right at the last minute, something's quite liable to grab it. Let's have a cast to the right now. Long one. And let it go. Let it sink right the way down. I wouldn't be surprised if the splash of that dead bait alone doesn't put any Nile perch within a 30 or 40 yard radius on its guard and on the lookout, hopefully. I don't want to let it sink too far in case it gets wedged in the rocks, but. And this is, of course, the trouble when you work in lures and I suppose dead baits. You don't want it to go too deep. You don't want to be in a snag before you even start playing a fish. There, something's got it. Something's got it. Whoa, look at that. Look at the way the line's leaving the reel. Whoa, look at that. Now, let's hope it's got it a fair way down because I'm going to hit it now. Clutch goes in. Yes, here we are. Oh, it's off. Oh, dear me. I didn't give it long enough. Oh, it's on again. Yes, it is. Would you believe it? It's taking it again. I think it's on all right this time. Oh, oh, it's burnt my hand. Oh, wow. That was an unbelievable take. That really was an unbelievable take. I'm going to get a bit closer here. I can get closer now as I've hooked one. I'm not going to spook him. Whoa, that's a good fish too. That is a good fish. Well, would you believe? Dead baiting for Nile perch, pike style. Just twitching a dead bait. Lovely. Oh, that feels a good fish. It's still taking line, but the only trouble is there's one or two very big boulders there. I can see them. Cast eyes on the bottom, and I don't want to lose it. I'm going to have to yell for Mohammed in a minute. Mohammed, do you... I don't think this is ready yet, but it'd be nice if you get your glove on. Thanks. No, where is it? Okay. Oh, it's a good fish. Have a lure in. Oh, look, you can see that big... Yes, here it is. Oh, that's a lovely one. Look at that. Yes! Is that a good fish or not? What's that, Mohammed? 60, 70? Yeah. Looks a good one, doesn't it? Looks a good fish. I think it's well hooked as well. Wow! Got to keep it away from these big boulders. Whoa! Now be careful, there's a flying hook on there, okay? So be careful of the flying hook. Well, I'm going to try this dead baiting again. Tim and I were talking about it earlier on and we bumped into some local fishermen and we swapped a few of these local dead baits. Bingo! Well done, Mohammed. Oh, let's take my polarizer off. Oh, right. I'm going to put the rod out of the way and we'll have a look at it. Do you want to lift him up? Watch that other hook there. That's a good fish, isn't it? Is it heavy? Just put him here so we can have a look at him. Oh, well, you're a lot stronger than I am. Now that's got to be, I would think, 60. Whoops. Hold his mouth open, I'll try and get that other hook out. Okay. Right, there we are. There's the panel rig. The line's come untwisted, but that's two size 8-0s in tandem on the 90-pound trace. Right, let's have a look at that. That's a lovely fish, isn't it? Isn't it dark? Look at that. Huge mouth. Look at that mouth. Let's hold him up, Mohammed.
Yes.
Well, what about that? Slinging a dead bait around pike style and second cast. What a place, huh? What a place.
Okay.
Whoa! Did he go or what? That's a nice fish, isn't it? Could be fatter, that, isn't it? It's got an enormous width there.
That's where the weight is.
It is, isn't it? And here it is, an unusually long 75-pounder. But there were many more to come within that powerhouse 60 to 80 pounds bracket and on a variety of deep-running lures, each and every fish giving its all in explosive tail-walking leaps following deep, dogged battles. Some specimens were short, darkly coloured and fat with immense width across the shoulders, others being noticeably long and silvery with a pronounced humpty back. They were coming in all shapes and sizes, and seeing them crash out across the waves behind the boat amounted to some of the most exciting sport I've ever experienced. Then my rod arched over like it never has before, as a big perch lunged on the surface before diving deep.
Tell you what, this is a good fish, Andy. I better go slow with this, Tim. Huh? What do you think?
You've got all the time in the world, John.
Yeah.
Getting a little bit of line on it. It was keeping very deep. Very deep. Feels lovely. It's coming up. I don't like the fact that that's coming up. I want it to stay there. I'm just letting this have its head with a little bit of finger pressure on the spool. I don't put too much strain on it. It's getting a bit hot there. Right. Okay. Lovely, right.
Finally, after a decade of near misses, on both Lake Victoria in Kenya and here on Lake Nasser, was I actually securely connected to a 100-pounder at last? Only time would tell.
Where is it, Tim? Here it is.
Suddenly, the great fish surfaced alongside, totally exhausted, straight into Mohammed's strong hands. And then he steered the boat while Tim gently towed the perch ashore for weighing. I'd finally cracked it.
What about that then? 120 pounds of muscle.
Thanks for helping me with it, Mohammed.
Can't believe it.